Hi everyone, I'm Alessia Visconti, I'm a postdoc at the Department of Twin Research at King's College London, and today I'm going to describe you the pipeline we developed to analyze the gut metagenomic data we collected in our cohort. We call it our pipeline YAMP, that stands for yet another metagenomic pipeline, and a very legitimate question is why another one? The answer is very trivial, it's because we were not happy with what was available out there. In fact, we wanted something that was easy to use, something everyone can run. You don't need to be an IT or a metagenomic expert to run your analysis. And we also wanted something that was not easy to run by everyone, but also everywhere on your local machine, on an HPC facility, on Amazon Cloud. We wanted our pipeline to be flexible, where user can just run part of it, or where more expert user can add, remove, or customize the existing steps easily. We also wanted to allow for reproducibility. If you give your data and your configuration file to someone else, this person with YAMP must be able to obtain your very same results. So how did we reach our objectives? We took advantage of two well-known frameworks. The first one is Nextflow. We heard about it before, but briefly, Nextflow allows to write workflows that are highly parallel and easily portable, also in distributed system. And workflow written in Nextflow are very flexible and easy to customize. The second framework we took advantage of is Docker. Everyone knows about it. Docker with this container allows for lightweight, self-contained system where all the software are installed at the right version along with all their dependencies. So now we know why and how. Let's see what YAMP does. YAMP allows the processing of metagenomic data from raw reads up to the community characterization and is divided into main analysis blocks, the quality control and the community characterization. In the quality control, we implemented three different steps. The first one is the deduplication. Here we remove identical reads in order to control for technical artifact. This step is followed by the trimming, where we trim out adapter and low-quality bases, and we also discard reads that became too short. And the final step is the decontamination. In fact, metagenomic data are never collected in isolation and may always be the presence of some foreign genome. For instance, we are working with the human gut, and the contaminant here is the human genome that we remove in this step. All the quality control is performed with tools that belong to the BBMAP suite. They are Clumpify for the duplication, BBDuck for trimming, and BBWrap for decontamination. The actual quality control is also accompanied by several steps of quality visualization and assessment that are all carried on with FastQC. The second analysis block is the community characterization. Here we aim at understanding what microbes are there and in which proportion. And to do so, we use the taxonomic binning and profiling implemented in Metaflan 2. But we also want to understand what these microbes are doing. And to answer this question, we use the functional annotation of the Human 2 pipeline. In this analysis block, we also use one of the QIMA modules for assess several measures of alpha diversity. The user can run the pipeline start to end or can limit its analysis to one of the two analysis blocks. So either stop at the quality control or use externally QC'd reads for the community characterization. So where you can find YAMP? YAMP is available on my GitHub page at that address. On the GitHub, along with the actual workflow, you also find a configuration file with all the parameter preset. So if you trust us, you can run your analysis straight away. In the GitHub, there is also a wiki with several tutorials on how to run YAMP, how to run YAMP on HPC with externally QC'd reads or with Docker. And in Docker Hub, at the address reported in the bottom, you also find the Docker image with all the software you need to run YAMP. So again, you are ready to go straight away. So time to thank the people that worked with me. First of all, Mario and Tiffen that trusted me on this project, but also Brian and Paolo with whom I had a very helpful online conversation. And thanks also to all of you for your attention.